Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the Brockton Public Schools Jazz Concert for this evening. You will hear three different groups tonight. The All City Middle School Jazz Band, which is on the stage in front of you, the Brockton Junior Jazz Band, and the Brockton Senior Jazz Band. If you did not get a program, there are programs in the back. We forgot to put them out when some of you snuck in, but I think most of you might have gotten them by now. So sit back tonight, enjoy, and you're going to hear a lot of hard work. I know for the fact for my group, the Junior Jazz, that group has not played a concert in 3 years. We were preparing a concert in 2020 when things got shut down. The group didn't even exist last year because of just rehearsals and trying to logistically get things together. We're very happy to be up here on stage performing for you guys. What a wonderful stage to be playing on. We have all the stuff that's being built for the musical. And we'll talk a little bit about the musical a little bit later in the concert. So sit back, enjoy. And our first group is the All City Middle School Jazz Band under the direction of Mr. Andrew Fantuccio and Mr. Maxwell Parker. And I'll bring Mr. Fantuccio up first.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you very much. So, as Mr. Cardell said, this is the All-City Jazz Band. So this is a group that is made up of middle school band students from across the city. They give up their time on Wednesday nights, basically every Wednesday night, from the beginning of October until now, to work on this and for many of them be introduced to the art form of jazz for the first time. Also, just to echo what Mr. Cardell said, how wonderful it is to be up here playing in a jazz concert again. It's been 3 years for this group as well since we have seen that, and what a wonderful group of students we got for this year too. Again, they've never played in a jazz ensemble together before, and they're gelling really, really well. So thank you to them. Yeah. So in addition to the multitude of styles that you'll hear in all of the songs that we do tonight, one of the pillars of jazz music is improvised soloing. Mr. Parker and I were doing the math, and I believe we have something like 23 solos that you're going to hear just on the set for this band. And we're going to be passing it around a lot of different instruments and a lot of different students. But I do want to acknowledge those students who had a solo in that piece that you just heard. On Barry Sachs, Ivan Mejia. On the vibraphone, Lenny Graff. On alto saxophone, Roy Radler. Also on alto saxophone, Chris Miller. On bass guitar, Mackley Bernadeau. On tenor saxophone, Steve Rojas. On trumpet, Abby Manzueta. Another alto saxophone, Andrew Bassett. And then at the end on drums, Aptalina Dorval. She's over there waving. All right, so that first tune, Firewalker, that was in the Latin style of jazz. Sort of there's like the three big styles we think about in jazz. And you're going to hear all of them tonight. There's Latin music, rock music, and of course swing music, which is what a lot of people probably associate when they think about jazz. And that's what our next tune falls under. This is in the modal jazz style, which was pioneered by musicians like Miles Davis and John Coltrane. And it's going to be sort of in that sort of style. We hope you enjoy it. This is Blue and Moody. Thank you very much. Solos on that one on the trumpet. That was Logan LaCara. And once again on alto saxophone, Roy Rattler. I do want to mention, most of you have figured it out at this point, in a concert like this, in a jazz concert, sorry people at home, it is appropriate to clap for the soloist as soon as the solo is done, so please feel free. That is not uncouth in this setting, so thank you very much. Now, in addition to working with these students, I feel I am very lucky to sort of have a partner in crime, as it were, in these ensembles. And for the first time joining us this year is Mr. Parker. And he's just done a wonderful job working with these students as well. So for the next two tunes, you're going to hear it. It's my pleasure to welcome onto the stage Mr. Maxwell Parker. Thank you.
Thank you so much. This group is an absolute blast to work with. I've had so much fun in these Wednesday night rehearsals that we get to do. And this is my first time with this group, but man, the talent on this stage is incredible. But not just the talent, but the work ethic that these guys have put in over the last few months is really impressive. So please, give these guys a hand. They've done so much work. So specifically, that last tune, Yardbird Suite, the famous Charlie Parker tune, we had Daniel DeRosa on trumpet and Andrew Bassett. Oh, yeah, there you go. Andrew Bassett on saxophone. And Haley Mark on tenor. Yeah. So the next tune we're going to do is a jazz standard called Mr. PC. We hope you enjoy. So much soloists on that one. Haley Mark on tenor sax. Abby Menzuetta on trumpet. Matthew Bernadeau on bass guitar. And Steve Rojas on tenor sax. All right, so we have one more song for you. I'm going to bring back out Mr. Fantuccio to finish us out before we bring up some extra friends onto the stage. So, Mr. Fantuccio.
All right, so for our last one, since I'll get through the announcing of it now, this one is going to be in the rock style, so you know, a little bit heavier, a little bit more energetic, definitely. Okay, we got a rock fan in the audience. There we go. So we hope you enjoy it. We'll talk about the solos after. This is Grooved Pavement Ahead. Thank you. Real quick, on the trombone, that was Junior El Cipina. Once again, on vibraphone, Lenny Graff. Again, on the Barry Sax, Ivan Mejia. And on alto saxophone again, Chris Miller. And once again on drums, Aptalina Dorval. Thank you. We hope you enjoyed the portion of the concert for just the All City Jazz Band. We have something a little extra to do. I guess we can start bringing them up now. We are going to, every year at this concert, it's been 3 years, but hey, every year at this concert, the All City Jazz Band and the Junior Jazz Band combine to perform one piece. We rehearse at the same time frame on the same night, just, you know, two rooms apart from each other, so we have the opportunity to get together and collaborate a little bit and play together. So you're about to hear a massively large jazz ensemble. And when Mr. Cardell gets up here, I'll let him introduce the tune. So bear with us for a brief little set change here. Thank you.
All right. So again, as Mr. Fantucci said, what you're looking at up here is the combined groups of the Junior Jazz and the All City group. Probably about a month ago, maybe a little bit more than that. For those of you that don't know, I did 24 and a half years in the United States Army. Three of those were in, thank you. Three of those were on active duty. I was stationed in Louisiana. And the other 21 and a half, I was stationed in the National Guard in Fall River. And you know, who knew, but they had music. So I was a musician for 24 and a half years in the Army. But one of the things that I absolutely loved about the time that I lived in New Orleans was the music that they had down there. And, you know, there you walk down Bourbon Street in New Orleans and, you know, just all the clubs and the jazz and everything. And I absolutely fell in love with the music down there. And there's a style of music that's down there. If you ever get a chance to go, it's called brass band. And it stems from the funeral services that are down there. And they're called jazz funerals. And they have a band that plays for the funeral. And they march the casket down the street to the gravesite. And it's very slow and very solemn. And when the casket enters the ground, they feel like that person has passed on to a better place and off to a better life. And so it's time to celebrate, and they party. And they party really strong. And the music that they play after that is really upbeat and very uplifting. And so when I came back to Massachusetts and the National Guard band that I was in, we decided to start a New Orleans-style brass band in the National Guard. And so I played with that group for about 15 years. And the group is still going strong. They still exist. And so I just called up my buddies down at the National Guard, and I said, hey, listen, we're doing this piece called Good Night in New Orleans. It's in a brass band style. Would you guys come and play for us? So about a month ago, they showed up. I think it was probably maybe 6 weeks ago. They showed up on a Wednesday night, which is unusual for them because they all have regular jobs like we do. And they showed up on a Wednesday night, and they played for about 2 hours for our kids. And then brought the kids up and had them playing along with them for the last song. And it was really a great experience, and the joy on their faces to see that, you know, this style of music. So we're going to feature a lot of people on here, too many to name. So I'm just going to say, if you played a solo, stand up and wave. And but this is our version of A Good Night in New Orleans.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. If you had a solo, stand up, take a wave. Very good. All right, one more quick set change. We'll get the All-City group off stage and set up for Junior Jazz, so give us 5 minutes.
One more quick announcement from the All-City Jazz Band. I almost forgot. So the group that you saw, it was not just myself and Mr. Parker up there. We actually had two senior band members of the Senior Jazz Band, who also gave up their time and their efforts to help with really everything we asked them to. From making copies all the way to helping and assisting with improv and sectionals and things like that. So a lot of the success of that group, we certainly owe to them as well. So if they could stand up, Kyle Gildner and Maisel Samba. And you'll get to hear them play later too. So thank you. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Soloists on that one, Stacy on alto saxophone. Jahir on tenor saxophone. Steve on trumpet. And Omaru on trombone. One of the things I like working with this group is not only can you play jazz, you can play, you know, you can play Latin music, you can play rock and roll, you can play all these sorts of things. And for a very long time, I was very involved in playing with an R&B group that had a horn section, and just fell in love with that genre of music. And so we're gonna feature a very surprise to me, because I didn't know that she actually sung. And we pulled the song out, and I said, "Hey, we're gonna audition for vocalists." And she raised her hand. She said, "Can I do it?" And I went, "I don't know you sing, so yeah, you can audition." And so through lots of trials and tribulations and struggles and tears, we're gonna bring Rhea up to sing for you, "Natural Woman." Great. Thank you very much. That also featured Kyle on tenor saxophone from the senior jazz band. All right, we're gonna change it up just a little bit. It's our time to do something a little funky as well. This is our version of Chris Berg's Kickin'. Dance a little bit. It's a long chart. You need two stands. Thank you very much. That song featured Amaro and Tyler on trombone. Jahir, Anna, and Josiah on saxophone. And Alessandra, Jason, and Elijah on trumpet. As Mr. Fantuccio said earlier, one of the great things about having the younger groups is that we get to pillage from the older group and bring them in to help out. And so I've had the privilege of having two teaching assistants this year for me. Both of them are thinking about going into music, and it's something that I strongly believe that, you know, giving them an opportunity to be in front of a group and work out some of the nerves of just trying to speak and, you know, teach what you need to get across to the kids. So the last two songs that we're going to do tonight are conducted by my two teaching assistants. Again, I like putting them in the spotlight. So the first of those is Rakim. Rakim is a senior attending Colorado College. Like, oh, I got it. I remembered. And he will be majoring in music there, and he's told me on only about 1,000 occasions that I can't retire until after he graduates because he wants to take my job. You didn't think I was going to let you get away with that, right? all right. So, however, I do want to mention we did also have a number of other senior jazz band members that came in and helped out, and I know they just left, but I would like to publicly acknowledge them. Also, James had come in and worked with the trumpets. Robbie had been here working with the saxophones. Am I missing anybody else? That was it, right? Oh, Paul. That's right. Yeah, and Paul was here working with the trombones. Yeah, Paul. That's right. All right, so I'm going to bring up Rakim, and he's going to conduct for you a piece from Incredibles 2, the movie. This is Digging the New Digs. Thank you. Thank you. One more hand for Rakim. Rakim. I didn't rehearse that song at all. That's all him. He rehearsed that one. Our soloists on that one, Ahuna on alto saxophone, Marcel on trombone, and Elijah on trumpet. Now, someone out there was hooping and hollering for some rock and roll, so we're going to amp it up a little bit, and we're going to play some heavy metal. Yeah. I found this piece. So I didn't say this. All the music that we're performing tonight was my program from 3 years ago when we got shut down. And I said, I really liked the program and I wanted to bring it, so I didn't have to buy anything new. We already had the music, so we're doing this one tonight. And it just so happens that it works out perfectly because Rakim happens to be a very talented guitar player as well. So we're going to feature him on Metallica's Enter Sandman. Oh, sorry. Yeah, thank you. Sorry, I got to bring the conductor up too. So my second teaching assistant that I had this year is he's a junior, so hopefully he'll be doing this again next year. This is McDaniel. Now that's rock and roll. Me too. Wow. Oh. All right. Junior Jazz, take your seats. We'll bring Senior Jazz up in a minute. Give us 5 minutes to set change, please. Thank you.
Good evening, everyone. I am pleased to do the Brockton High School Jazz Ensemble for one more time, shall we say. It's a pleasure coming back in the afternoon and helping the students and working with these students. Before we start, I just want to make sure how proud, I just want to say this. How proud I am of this group. I've had incredible groups performing before, but none of them had to come out here during this COVID and sit outside from 3 o'clock to 5 o'clock freezing, 6 feet apart, and they showed up. And they came in and they worked hard. And I'll tell you, the night that we went to perform at the district, and gold medal was sounded by the judges, how they exploded in happiness. It was just an unbelievable feeling for me to see all that work that they did. So I just want to put that right up front. As a matter of fact, they were so excited that there was a couple out there, and the gentleman said to me, "What do you feed them?" I said, "I don't know, they're just an excited bunch of kids." So I just want to say that right up front, how proud I've done what the work that they've done with such little time. So we like to start off with three of our first tunes are the ones we did at the competition in district and all state. And so we'll start off with Crescent River Ramble. Vai for Summer on alto. Well done on tenor sax. And I do want to say that they both got outstanding musicians that night by the judges, chose two outstanding musicians, and they're on. So, for the second tune, we'd like to slow down a little bit, a little Count Basie style. I hear we try to teach all styles of music, and we'll get to the lady that loves the rock in the back that shouted out. We got one for you. I knew you wanted one. That was a joke. I pity for you. Wow. You think they bat at home? Yes, they can't remember anything. We just talked about that. We got it. Absolutely. Very good. That was good.
We'll get it next time.
Next time. Yeah, thank you. So we like to do a little Count Basie style of music, which is really teaching the old big bands type of blues and laid-back stuff, which is actually more difficult to play than the fast, loud stuff. So here's a tune called The Good Life, and you'll feature Count in there on tenor sax. Anybody else? Okay. Well, while we get this set up, as you can see, there are many young students, and we talk about this all the time. I'm sure they hear it by Mr. Fantucci and Mr. Gardell and the teachers' elementaries. You don't get to a point like this by not practicing or leaving your saxophone or clarinet or whatever underneath the bed. This is the size of the group that will come out of all those kids that appear. Eventually, only five of each or four or five, the maximum is the size. So there's a lot of competition. This is an audition group. You have to audition every year, even them. At the end of the year, we start all over again. Somebody else that plays better than you, then they come in. This is a competitive group. We've been doing like that since this was started. Well, I started this thing in 1971, and it's been going on forever. And we have some top-notch jazz players in this country that came out of here from this stage. So the school system here has really provided, all the years that I've been here, wonderful support, including the parents, to these kids, so we can experience. We're talking about how to work together. Well, there you are. Jazz is working together. Many cultures put together. So, when they're not doing anything, take the phone away for about a half an hour and let them practice for an hour. It will help because they will come up and compete. And if they can go out there and get some lessons, that's even better. Okay, so we can maintain all the levels that we come down here.
What's the matter? It's the amp, it's not the cord.
All right, we'll just have to do that.
Thank you.
do go and perform for judges, very different variations, and believe it or not, music is graded. And a school like this, you can't play grade one, grade two, grade three, you've got to go up there and play grade five, which is one of the very difficult music to perform. So you give them the challenge to want, and they've done an outstanding job this year from this piece. So it's the piece is called Madrid. It's incredible Spanish sounds and samba and so on all put together, and really proud of what they've done. This Nota de Rosa on trombone will be featured. Anybody else? Nilton, the Massachusetts Music Educators Association has what they call district, all state, and the junior high district, and so on. And the best musicians from all over the from all over Massachusetts, once you make, if you make district and you get all state recommendation, well, think about this, if you're a trumpet player, trombone, saxophone player, you're competing with the best saxophone player, trumpet players, and trombone players of all the high schools in Massachusetts. And Nilton was one to be chosen for that. So that's quite an accomplishment. Okay? And Mr. and Mrs. DeRosa, he's finally talking. I know you don't like that, but he's finally talking. We actually had a conversation of five words the other day. Thank you. Switch a little bit. We go to some of the classics, and we introduce some of the classic jazz back in the 30s and 40s. Some beautiful melody were written at that time, which you've heard it. It's still alive today. Believe it or not, that's so many years. And this gentleman is interested because he's written a lot of TV theme songs. One of the TV songs, believe it or not, it has no music to it. All you see is a father and a little kid going fishing, whistling. Who would that be? Yes, right. Andy Mayberry. Yeah. Earl Hagen wrote this gorgeous ballad by the name Harlem Nocturne. And you really need a sweet saxophone player to play that. And we do have one of those people today to perform you this beautiful classic ballad, Harlem Nocturne. Thank you. this other tune that was around the 30s and 40s, big dance number, actually has a tie to Brockton. This is a tune which Artie Shaw performed. The great man Artie Shaw was a great clarinet player. And when he passed away, he said that I don't want anybody else to play my part. He was a clarinet player. And he said, I don't want anyone else to leave my band and play the clarinet part. None other than Dick Johnson from Brockton, Massachusetts. For you people that have been here for a long time, one of the greatest saxophone players in this country. He lived right here. And I had the pleasure of knowing him and playing with him. And his son was, Gary Johnson, who's a professional drummer right now, was the first drummer in 1972-73 in his band. So Dick was just a marvelous, those people do remember. He was a legend, and unfortunately sometimes when you have it in your own house, you don't appreciate it. He was more appreciated outside than sometimes, when it's at it. But he was a great man. So he left the original chart to us. To me, Eddie says, you take care of it, and when you find a clarinet player that plays beautifully, he says, you let me know, and we do. So we're going to feature Beginning to Begin, which is, again, recognized. I know some of you young people are young, the big bands, but they're still alive very well with us. So we're going to feature Kyle Gilner. Since he's going to music, he better learn all the different instruments if he wants to get anywhere. So, Kyle, we're going to feature Kyle Gilner on Begin to Begin. Thank you. So we're going to go to a whole new medium of today, and one last tune back in the 70s, jazz rock style, which it's something that's coming back because these kids have no place to play unless you had horns to whatever their music is called today. But you know that piece, it's a wonderful piece. But the first one, it's not in a program, but we all of us try to teach improvisation. Improvisation is something you spontaneously do at the moment. It's nothing that's written out. To improvise on a set of chords that fits the melodic pattern and so on and so on. It's not just something just blowing notes wherever you want. So the first thing you do to learn how to improvise is to learn how to stand up. So once they learn to stand up, get scared, they've got to do it for themselves. At first, they kind of, I don't want to do this, I don't want to do this. No, don't think about me and so on. So finally, I'm just going to point at people tonight, and they better be ready. Okay, so when they do it, it's, you know, music is brain developing. There's a lot of things going on in their heads there, and, you know, all towards processing and learning. So we're going to do a little thing by. I know him. Yeah. Lawrence Walk. No. Bruno Mars. You know Bruno Mars, right? He was here the other night. You missed him. All right, so what we're going to do is we're going to do a little bit here and just open it up a little bit quick. One here, and then we'll close up with a nice piece from the old style of the late 70s of jazz rock. Here's Bruno Mars, Runaway Baby. Thank you. fine, that's sad. Anyway, we're going to close up, and we're very happy that you came up here with support and make sure that they practice. Sometimes they wait a little too long to get serious. And I do mean it sometimes. We don't know how they come in, they don't talk, they don't say anything, and then all of a sudden, the junior year, something happened. Right, Aggie? Yeah. And no one has stayed up to do a solo for two solid years. Look at him. So, see, first he learned how to stand up, but he's already standing up anyway, so I didn't have to do anything about that. But anyway, we want to thank you. I'm sure Mr. Cardell has something to say, and Mr. Fantuccio, with all the group here. Again, there's a show coming up. Mr. Prasim to Hello Dolly, some of the students will be involved. I always feel that sometimes people see not the good side of what the school is all about. And I've watched that, believe it's just not now, I've watched this for 49 years. They never talk about the good kids, but I think that happens. And this is fun. The great teachers, you know, it really is. So I have to give a shout out to these two guys. They did this thing throughout all the COVID, through computers and stuff that I don't know how Mr. Cardell and Mr. Fantucci did that, and just amazing what they turned out in such a short amount of time. Yeah, you need to stand up on that. Oh, I'm sorry. Maxwell, I'm sorry. He's at the, you are at Asheville School in Instrumental. Yeah, thank you for working. Sorry, it's gone, too many things. All right, so we close up with a little beautiful sound of a tune called Vehicle by the Eyes of March. I don't know if you remember that, but it's a cool tune. Here it is.
One, two.
Start them up here, bring them up here. Thank you so much, Mr. Cardell. Mr. Cardell, you want to say something? You all set? Please drive carefully and hope that everything goes well. Thank you.